Senator Tim Kaine here on the Brody File. Senator, good to see you, sir.
David, yeah, great to be with you, man. Thanks.
Look, we have quite a few topics, but let's start with Syria.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me a little bit. There's a conflict in the Christian community, quite frankly, all over America.
Yeah,
what to do with these Syrian refugees? What's your take, maybe more specifically from a Christian perspective on all of this?
Yeah, well, it is a hard choice, and American security has to come first. But we also have to be very careful that we don't betray our own values. There is a bill that passed the House that's securing America against foreign enemies is the title of the bill. These refugees are not our enemies. ISIL's our enemy, and Congress won't act to declare war against ISIL. But within a very short time, you know, a bill was passed in the House kind of labeling these refugees as our enemies. These are folks who are fleeing the atrocities of Bashar al-Assad's barrel bombs. They're fleeing, you know, persecution of Christians and religious minorities, forcing women into sexual slavery and other kinds of humanitarian atrocities and beheadings by ISIL. This is the worst humanitarian crisis since World War II. And the U.S. is a nation that has traditionally been a place of liberty, a statue of liberty, and a refuge. And from a Christian standpoint, you know, I even kind of go back to the book of Job in the Old Testament, which is important to Christians, Jews, and Muslims, because it's in the Quran too. Job had a lot of bad things happen to him. But it wasn't because he was sinful, and it wasn't because the world was evil. It was because he was being tested to see if he'd stay true to his principles and his faith, or whether he would abandon his faith, you know, in adversity, he would suddenly stop relying on God. We can't abandon our principles because there's terrorism in the world. And one of our principles has been that we've been that Statue of Liberty nation. So I hope what we'll do, and I think maybe a week or so into this, we're kind of getting to this place where we were really precise about what we need to do to protect American security, but we don't, with a big tar brush, you know, paint all these refugees as if they're enemies. No, these are the victims of the worst humanitarian crisis since World War II.